first race down toward the U.S. Air Force flyway from the outside. Brendan Lemieux going to do what he did in round number one as he gets the stud point hole shot.
That pole shot ever so important, but it looks like Cody Cam able to rip on the inside. He is able to gain the lead heading onto the back straightaway.
Yeah, Cody Cam on the Hentges Racing Monster Energy Polaris getting out there, and now there's a battle right behind him. They're all jamming up in the corner, and Hunter Patnode putting the bar right alongside of Logan Christian there and gets out ahead of them as they battle down into the FXR turn.
And Logan Christian going over the berm, but he's able to get things back on track and actually try a bit of a crossover move to take the inside now. Here we have our eyes on Lincoln Lemieux, who's currently out towards the front here, actually leading this one.
Yeah, Cody Cam trying to get up alongside. Oh, and Lincoln gets out of the berm and stuck for a moment. Kadu's going to go and slide by. Lincoln will recover, and that hands the lead to Cody Cam.
Very tough. Just a minor miscalculation there, but you see Lincoln, he's trying to make up some ground here on the outside line.
Yeah, I think he is ticked off on himself right now because he just blasted past Kadu. And that means his net loss was only one spot with that whole scenario. Now he's going to go chase after Cody Cam, trying to get back up there on the point. Meanwhile, his teammate Hunter Patnode in the mix battling with Kadu and Whitworth coming from the back row.
And Cole Kadu, who's up there in the mix, this would be a very solid qualifier finish for him. His best qualifier finish this season. He does have a third, and that was just a few weeks ago in Iowa. But a number of fourth place finishes in the qualifiers for Colton Sioux, who has Trent Whitworth just behind him, who started on the back row, so he's making moves.
Yeah, Whitworth has worked his way up now. He's challenging Colton Sioux for third. Patnode giving chase on the Amsoil U.S. Air Force Skidoo. He'll go to the outside of the FXR turn. Whitworth on the inside. As he blasts that R12 D&D sled up over the Amsoil finish line, jump chasing after Colt Kadu's Polaris. Meanwhile, still Cody Cam and Lincoln Lemieux running 1 and 2. And Whitworth gets by a little bobblehead for Kadu. And now Patnode trying to get by as well on the inside.
A little bit of contact there as presented by Trent Whitworth. But he did what he had to do. Nothing too dirty there. Just had to force it. And it paid off for him. As he's found himself, currently, I believe, in the third place position.
So Whitworth moving up. He was a winner in round one qualifying and now trying to make the best of a back row start and doing pretty good with it here, moving up into the third position. Kadu flares out wide, just could not get those skis to bite. And that allows Hunter Patnode to move through, so Patnode will now go up into the number four spot.
Hunter Patnode says, heading into this weekend, that he's humble, healthy, and happy. Year two, he had healed up a little bit from Fargo, and that was just from back-to-back-to-back races. They really needed these 2 weeks off just to rest and recuperate for this run.
So Patnode trying to keep Kadu behind him now that he's made the pass, gapped out by a couple of sled lengths here over the U.S. Air Force flyaway. At the front of the field, still Cam leading Lincoln Lemieux in this Amsoil Pro Qualifier. And the gap between the two sits at about 5 seconds. So Cody is really showing some strength here in this Amsoil Pro Qualifier on that Hentges Racing Polaris.
He really is. And has a comfortable gap. And we've seen a few position exchanges between Lincoln Lemieux and Cody Cam. Cody Cam looking so strong here. He continuously makes gains each weekend. But this qualifier, when if he's able to solidify it, it's a white flag fly. This is big for Cody.
Cody will stay down on the low side here through the Arcat corner. Powers out towards the Polaris rhythm section. Nice and smooth. Over the U.S. Air Force flyaway. And he'll find his way into the FXR turn here for the final time. Ducks a little roost from a sled in front of him. He'll come to the Amsoil finish line as the winner in this Amsoil Pro Qualifier. So Cody Cam gets the top spot. Lincoln Lemieux coming across for second. Right behind him, Trent Whitworth in for third. Followed by Patnode and Cole Kadu. And right behind Kadu is Aki Balaya, Logan Christian, and Oscar Norm. Norm, not a very good qualifying efforts here tonight, unfortunately, for the second place man in the point standing. So we get ready for heat number two as they get ready to go here at the lawn.
So we see there on Eno Harsla, that Jednik ride, what they're doing packing snow on top of the tunnel is they want a cool motor, but they want a hot clutch and hot pipe. So that's what they're doing, packing that snow on for a little bit of insulation in order to keep that snow. What they're actually doing is refrigeration, I should say, keep that motor cool. But again, that cool motor, hot pipe, hot clutch.
Francis Peltier getting ready to go as he hops on his Makita Rockstar Skidoo. Francis coming up from the Pro Light division last year, as Hunter Patino did. There's Travis Muller.
Travis Muller and his mechanic, Zach Ignashevsky. And we actually have his brother Peter is also a mechanic. He is out here in the pits as well somewhere. But Travis Muller, not one of our full-time runners anymore. But if in case you missed the U.S. Air Force pit walk, we dropped some knowledge on you. Actually, Travis informed me of this earlier this week. Only current rider in the field, and actually one of the only riders to win on all three major brands.
There's Emil Haar getting his sled ready to fire up. Francis Peltier going through his little pre-race routine. Emil Haar getting his Judnick sled squared away. See him stepping down on the back end there, trying to push those tracks down into the snow so they can get maximum traction on the launch.
That's right, and lined up right next to Haar, we have Jake Yerk, who won just a few weight games ago for his first pro win in Deadwood, South Dakota.
And in the middle of the pack there, right next to Peltier, your point leader, Elias Ishul. All the way to the inside, Kyle Pauline. From the middle, hard launch here for Peltier. Now they are five wide as they come across the U.S. Air Force flyaway. Nobody's got the distinct advantage yet. Peltier will come out the other side, and Emil Haar charging up alongside of them. They'll be battling for the lead here as they head into the ramp trucks rhythm section.
Talking about Makita power for Francis Peltier and the Warner Racing crew, looking so great on this start, but still so bunched up here. We see the rest of our riders. We see Elias Ishul getting a bit buried in the pack.
Yeah, he got crossed up there a little bit, and he was trying to get back on the power, and the entire pack just kind of whistled by him, so he's going to be at the back of the bus. But have to work his way forward now as Peltier leads over the Amsoil finish line jump with Emil Haar in tow in second. Jacob Yerk is third. Here's a look at what happened to the Viking Rocket right here. This got crossed up there and made a little contact with Jacob Yerk, and that was enough to slow him down. But yeah, he's the Viking Rocket. He's back on the gas, already getting by Kyle Pauline, and now working to the outside. Pauline trying to come back here, but Ishul will have the position as they head to the Amsoil finish line jumping. Wow, he's long jumping. That's the first time we've seen anybody long jump the finish line like that.
Wow, look at the speed that we see the Viking Rocket carrying just out on the outside line of that turn. He's carrying some serious speed here as he goes over the U.S. Air Force flyway.
Yeah, Elias Ishul after a miscue like that, fast and dangerous. And he is just tearing his way through the pack. Let's see if he does that long jump again. Yep. He's found something. Oh, it cased at that time. Yerk's going to come back at him. But he's found something there that nobody else is doing.
And if the guy that's going to take risks and try things out there, it's going to be Elias Ishul. He's going to lay it all on the line. Jacob Yerk, he answers the call here. If he can put it on Elias Ishul here in his final turn before the finish line jump, we are just about at the halfway point of this qualifier.
And now Pauline coming back into the mix as well as Elias again airs it. Trying to catch up to Jacob Yerk and trying to jump to his inside here. Can't quite get him coming out of the Arctic Cat corner. Gets a face full of that roost. Pauline trying to come back at him on the outside. At the front of the field, Peltier has about 2 seconds on Emil Haar. Now Pauline's going to pull a crossover move.
Elias Ishul currently still charging his way up front there. With how many wins he's had in the finals, he's only had 3 qualifier wins this year. I know Elias Ishul has his sights set on a 4th win in a row. That would be his 7th overall this season, but there's still a lot of racing between now and then, as we're here heading on to lap 7 here coming up in just a moment.
Elias will drop down to the inside here as they launch into the FXR turn. He'll come out the other side ahead of Jacob Yerk. And again, he's going to go for the long jump here over the Amsoil finish line. Only one in the pack doing it. And he has now worked his way up to 3rd. So Elias again showing you that gear that he has, but he can just turn the speed on into the snap of a finger as he tears his way back up through the field. But he's still about 4 seconds behind your race leader, Francis Peltier, who is just coming down here toward the Amsoil finish line for the 2-to-go signal.
Francis Peltier, 2.309 seconds ahead of Emil Haar, who, you know, has a considerable gap over Elias Ishul, but Elias is on the move with just 3 laps here remaining.
And Pelletier tried to pull that same long jump move a lap ago that Elias Ischel was doing. And wound up casing him a little bit. Yurt, meanwhile, trying to come back on Ischel. So that battle's not done. Pauline is right in the mix as well as he sneaks up alongside Jacob Yurt. And Pauline goes for the long jump here to get by Yurt. And now that puts him within sight of Ischel. Not close enough to make a move in the corner. Yurt charges back on his outside. By the way, this is the final lap, and they're all fighting for a position.
We'll see if Kyle Pauline's going to be able to capitalize here as they head into the final turn.
So the win's going to go to Francis Pelletier on the Rockstar Makita's Canoe in his Amsoil Pro Qualifier. And Ischel will hold off Jacob Yurt and Pauline as they finish in spots 3, 4, and 5 behind Abel Haar. Travis Muller coming away with the sixth position. That was fun to watch right there. I can't wait to see what the pro final is going to look like later on. All right, when we come back, we're going to set the remainder of the starting field in Pro Light. Their LCQ is coming up. You're watching Amsoil Championship Snowcross powered by Ram Trucks.